At Elland Road, you could say it's been a day of two halves. This morning, the nation's media were kept waiting for a decision on whether the club would appeal against UEFA's decision that they must replace Stuttgart on a neutral ground. And this afternoon, it's Leeds United themselves who've been waiting, this time for a fax from Switzerland. John Shires has the details.
A busy week for Leeds officials. After Zurich on Saturday, another meeting at Elland Road today. As the players train for this week's Coca-Cola Cup tie at Scunthorpe, and who knows what else, the directors met for 2.5 hours. The outcome, as outlined by manager Howard Wilkinson, a more conciliatory approach than the bullish indications yesterday from chairman Leslie Silver that an appeal against UEFA's ruling was almost guaranteed. So, no formal appeal yet. Instead, representations that if there must be a replay, it should be at Elland Road, not a neutral ground. In a fax sent to UEFA, Leeds argue that since Stuttgart have broken the rules, it would be wrong to disadvantage Leeds by ordering a third match anywhere other than Elland Road. The breach of regulations took place there, so the deciding game should be held there as well. And if the game were to be staged on the continent, that would give a clear advantage to Stuttgart, a point amplified by the Leeds manager as he read out the facts sent to UEFA.
We would ask you to bear in mind that approximately 10 times more Leeds United supporters travel to Stuttgart than Stuttgart supporters travel to Leeds.
Beyond that, no comment, but surely a fervent hope that UEFA won't order the replay, wherever it is, to be played at the weekend. Gary McAllister, who scored a penalty in last Wednesday's second leg, David Batty and Tony De Rigo are all on World Cup qualifying duty for their countries next week. And Scotland's Andy Roxburgh and England's Graham Taylor have confirmed they won't be released to play for Leeds. That, of course, leaves the question of where. So far, a number of venues have been suggested, among them Copenhagen, Bern in Switzerland, Rotterdam, Paris and now Dublin. The question is, who would want to host the game with all its attendant problems at such short notice? And anyway, of those cities, authorities in Copenhagen say they're too busy, the Swiss FA say their stadiums aren't up to standard, Rotterdam has apparently been ruled out, and Paris is unlikely in view of the problems with Leeds fans at the 1975 European Cup final. Meanwhile, the debate about the rights and wrongs of the affair rages on. Today, fans from another German club, Werder Bremen, were being shown round Elland Road, and even they were divided about whether Stuttgart should have been eliminated.
I think it was also a mistake of the referee. He should have known that there were four foreign players.
It was stupid, and so they have to be thrown out.
Despite today's more conciliatory line, there's no doubt that there's still a burning feeling of injustice here at Elland Road. Many feel that the Germans, with the weight of their powerful football association, not to mention the Deutschmarks of the German TV networks behind them, had the odds heavily stacked in their favour at Saturday's meeting. Indeed, there are rumours that initially UEFA's disciplinary committee was considering imposing merely a fine on Stuttgart, and it was only some straight talking from the Leeds delegation that made them change their minds and order a replay instead. Meanwhile, this evening, Leeds were told that in response to their facts, UEFA are convening another meeting tonight. Further developments are expected tomorrow morning.